So here we go. So we'll understand what is called comparison of rational numbers. Now, how do we compare rational numbers? So, you know, to be very true to you, it's a very easiest thing to do. But conceptually, you have to learn a couple of methods. You have what is called a number line method according to your syllabus across various boards, whether you're in CBSE, ICSE. So there are particular styles that you're supposed to know. There is something called a number line method. Now, what is that number line method? Say, let's assume we have, rational numbers like, say, 2 by 3, say, 1 by 3, and say, 4 by 3, and say, 7 by 3 for that matter. So let's assume we have these rational numbers. So if you can see, all these rational numbers have a common denominator, which is 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. So I just took that example because it's easy for you to draw them on a number line. So you have a number line, you have a zero here, right? So we have, say, something like 1, 2, 3 on a number line and so on, right? So on the negative side, if you want to put, you have minus 1, minus 2 and so on, right? So how do we draw 2 by 3, 1 by 3, 4 by 3, 7 by 3? All of you know how to draw this. We learned in our last class. Okay. So where will that 1 by 3 and 2 by 3 will be there on this number line? Anyone?
Between 0 and 1.
Wonderful. So what we do, we divide this 0 and 1 into 3 equal parts. You can see these are the 3 equal parts. Right. This is one part, the second part. So we know this is 1 by 3. This is 1 by 3 and we know this is 2 by 3 and your 1 is nothing but 3 by 3. Your 1 is nothing but 3 by 3. Your 3 by 3 is nothing but 1. Therefore, you know that is 3 by 3. So we could trace 1 by 3 on this number line. We could trace 2 by 3 on this number line. Now we want 4 by 3. Where will 4 by 3 lie on this number line?
Between 1 and 2.
Very good. Because 4, you know, 4 by 3 is more than 1. So another way of looking at 4 by 3, if you are, you know, the another way of looking at 4 by 3, if I were to look at 4 by 3, another way to look at that is I can see this as 3 plus 1 divided by 3. So basically, it's 3 plus 1 in the numerator divided by 3. So I can separate this, I can see that as 3 by 3 plus 1 by 3, which is nothing but 3 by 3 is 1 plus 1 by 3. So I can see it's 1 by 3 more than 1. So basically, you can see that will be somewhere here, right? So basically, once again, if I divide 1 and 2 into 3 parts, so your 4 by 3 will lie here. So your 4 by 3 will lie there. And where will 7 by 3 lie? Or let me take 8 by 3 instead of 7 by 3. Let me give you 8 by 3.
Between 2 and 3?
Yeah, it'll be between 2 and 3. So will it be the first part or the second one? Yeah, which one? The first one or the second?
I think it'll be the second one.
Yeah, it'll be the second one because you know 8 by 3 technically is nothing but what? 8 by 3, if you look at it, it'll be, if it'll be 6 by 3. 6 by 3 would have been 2, so it's 2 plus 2 by 3. Can I say that? It's basically 8 by 3 is nothing but 2 plus 2 by 3 because you know it is 6 by 3 is 2. So it's basically 2 plus 2 by 3. So you can see, you can trace that out here and say that is 8 by 3. So you can always put these numbers on the number line. So when you see them on the number line, you can see your 1 by 3 is here. Let me take a different color to explain. Your 1 by 3 is here. Your 2 by 3 is here. Okay, and 4 by 3 is here, 8 by 3 is here. So, but I need not worry, you know, on a number line, any number on the left hand side is a lesser number. So we learned that in the previous classes. So on line, you know that, yeah, we know that 1 by 3 is definitely less than your 2 by 3 and your 2 by 3 is definitely less than, what is that, 4 by 3. And that is definitely less than 8 by 3. So when we have rational numbers, one way to define which number is less than the other number or which number is greater than the other number, the way that we do it is we put those numbers on the number line and decide which number is greater than the other or which number is less than the other. Okay, does that make sense? Do you understand this number line method? Everyone just mention yes if this is
yes,
clear.
Sir. Yes.
Good.
Yes, sir.
Good. So let's quickly go to, you know, an arithmetic process. Anyone know what is this arithmetical process?
I don't know the process, but I'm guessing it's not with a number line. It's probably pen and paper.
Okay.
Google math.
Very good. Very good. Yeah, that's a good guess, Arjun. Anyone who has already done rational numbers at school?
Actually, we did learn, but
I think the last time I learned it was fifth grade. After that, they never brought it up.
Okay, no problem.
Because that's fifth grade. Cambridge.
Okay, got it. So Veda is trying to write. I didn't hear about this. Okay, no problem, Veda. That's okay. So arithmetical process, it's a very simple process. Say, let's assume we have two numbers to start with. Let's assume we have one number, which is, say, 2 by 3, and another number, say, let's take, say, 3 by 5. Okay. So we have these two numbers, 2 by 3 and 3 by 5. Now we need to compare these two numbers. Now, basically, whenever we have two numbers or three numbers or four numbers, four rational numbers, any number of rational numbers, what does this arithmetical process tells you is arithmetically make your denominator same. So for example, you have 2 by 3 and 3 by 5. What you can do is you can, you know, what is the LCM of 3 and 5? LCM of 3 and 5 is 15. So what you can do is this ratio 2 by 3, this rational number 2 by 3, you can multiply this with 5 and divide this by 5. And you can do the same process here. Now, because you want LCM to be 5 into 3, 15, you want this denominator also to be same. Now, how can you do that? You have 5 there, you want 15. So you will multiply this with 3.
Times 3. You will multiply
this with 3, right? Yes. You multiply the numerator also with 3. So now what are you doing? What you are doing is this number now is converting into your ratio, which was 2 by 3, is now converting into 5 twos are 10 divided by 5 threes are 15. So you have a rational number 10 by 15. And now you have 3 by 5, which was your original rational number. Because of multiplying with 3 in the numerator and 3 in the denominator, the value doesn't change. And that gives you 3 threes are 9. 3 threes are 9 divided by 5 threes are 15. Now, by bringing them into the same denominator, you are doing basic arithmetic. You are doing mathematics. Basic arithmetic is nothing but doing multiplication, division, addition. You are doing arithmetic processes to bring it. Here in this case, no problem there. That's okay. That's okay. Absolutely fine. Is there any new student today in the class? Because this girl is supposed to join today.
Sure. Alex is new, I guess.
Yeah,
Alex.
Like he came on Monday.
No problem. That's fine. Okay. So you can see there is 10 by 15 here and 9 by 15. So now by looking at these two numbers, you can quickly decide which one is greater. Which one is greater?
10 by 15, sir. 15.
Of course, there is nothing great in this because you know in the natural numbers, when you have 10 and 9, your denominator is same. You know 10 by 15 is greater than 9 by 15. Therefore, now you can quickly decide that your 2 by 3 is greater than 3 by 5. I hope you understood. So let us take another example, whether you can do it or not. Let's check that quickly. Tell me between, say, okay. Tell me which is greater between 7 by 15 and 4 by 9. Tell me which is greater between 7 by 15 and 4 by 9. That's fine, dear. Dear. That's okay. Absolutely fine. Ritu, 4 by 9? No, Ritu, 4 by 9 is not Greta. No.
I got 7 by 15. So I got 7 by 15.
Yeah, 7 by 15 is the correct answer.
Yes, sir. 7 by 15 is the correct answer.
Correct. So, Ritu, why did you get it as 4 by 9? Ritu, what did you do? Ritu, because it's very important for you to understand. I don't want to go further if you don't understand. Small mistake I did. Okay, no problem. So, wonderful. So, if you can observe, very simple now. You can see LCM of 15 and 9. What's LCM of 15 and 9?
45.
Very good. 45 is the LCM of 15 and 9. So, you know, if I want 45 in the denominator, I need to multiply this with 5. I need to multiply this with 5. So, basically, here I need to multiply this with 3 and multiply this also with 3. Right? So, you get 3 sevens are 21 by 45. And in this case, you get 4 fives are 20 by 9 fives are 45. Right? So, from that, you can decide that 21 by 45, when you have the same denominator, you know 21 is greater. Then when you quickly say that 21, this is greater. Therefore, your 7 by 15 is greater than 4 by 9.
4 by 9.
Does that make sense to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Wonderful. Wonderful. So that is your regular method. Okay. So now this is called arithmetical process method. So before I go further, I think there are easy questions in the exercise. So let me give you something interesting little later. Until then, let's live with this arithmetical process. So I'll give you some tough questions wherein I'll teach you a different method to solve this quickly. Okay. So yes, let's go further and solve this. Tell me which of the two rational numbers, 3 by 5 and minus 2 by 3, which is greater?
3 by 5, sir.
Yes. So here there is nothing great to solve in this particular problem. The moment you can see there is a positive rational number, there is a negative rational number. So in a number line, negative rational number, you know it will be on the left side. Whatever is the value, I don't know. Let me not worry about it because I know it's minus 2 by 3 and I have 3 by 5. I know if it is 3 by 5, it will be positive. Therefore, that will be on the right side of a number line. So I need not even worry. I know that 3 by 5 will be greater. So when it comes to two rational numbers, which are one is positive, another is negative, I need not even worry. It has to be simple. Positive rational number will be greater than a negative rational number. Does that make sense to everyone? Very fundamental.
Yes,
but
sir.
You should, yes. But yeah. you should be able to quickly observe these things when you find problems. Okay?
Mr. Krishna, I have a question.
Yeah. You need not call me Mr. Krishna. You can call me Krishna. You can call me sir. Feel comfortable. Yeah, go ahead.
No, I'm just used to calling every teacher of mine Mr. So I'm sorry. But what's the difference between a rational number and a number?
Okay, don't worry. We have, I know I'm going there. I mean, it's part of my class today. We'll get there after. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. Okay, so I'll definitely answer your question. Just hold on. Okay?
Okay.
Good. So, now, whereas if the question were to be minus 3 by 5 and minus 2 by 3, now tell me which one is greater.
Minus 2 by 3.
I knew that, I know that most of you will make this mistake. Huh? The question is, which one is greater? Don't forget, the question is, which one is greater? Which one is greater? Minus 3 by 5 and minus 2 by 3. See, it's a very fundamental question. I can already see most of
you. Oh, it's minus 3 by 5.
Yeah, no. See, you're making mistakes. Very good, Akshat. You realized. Wonderful.
Of course. Because 3 by 5 is bigger than 2 by 3 usually, and then because it's a minus of columns.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Let's not make these mistakes once again. Let's look at this in a same way. We can apply the same logic. You have 5 and 3 denominator. Always get your denominator into a positive number. So assume your denominator is 5 and 3. That's there. So just multiply your numerator and denominator here into 3. And here you multiply and denominator with 5. So what will you get? 3 into minus 3 is minus 9 divided by 15. And you have minus 10 divided by 15. Now, when you have negative numbers, is minus 9 greater or minus 10 greater? On a number line?
Minus 9.
Ah, so your minus 9 is greater. So we know now because of this, you immediately know that your minus 9 is greater. Because your minus 9 is greater, that means this is greater. What do you mean by this is greater? That means your minus 3 by 5 is greater than minus 2 by 3. Does that make sense to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so please don't make these mistakes. People who made the mistake, please learn. It's very fundamental, but this is something which is done by most of the students. This is a standard mistake that most students go through. So very simple. Don't rush into the problem solving. Get your denominator positive. Bring it into the same denominator. Then compare your numerator. You will be able to understand. Wonderful. Thank you there. Let's go ahead.